And then we have two keynote addresses by very renowned personalities from finance and accounting professions. After dinner, we have an entertainment program that includes poetry, comedy, and music. So, ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for a very warm welcome to the Chairman Golden Jubilee Celebrations Committee, Hafiz Muhammad Yusuf.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In the name of Allah, the most beneficent, the most merciful. Our chief guest of the evening, Honorable Chief Justice Lahore High Court, Mr. Justice Sheikh Ahmed Said. Our keynote speakers, former Finance Minister of Pakistan, Mr. Shaukat Tareen. President Institute of Chartered Accountants in England and Wales, Mr. Clive Parrott. President Institute of Chartered Accountants of Pakistan, Mr. Rashad Rahman Mir, past presidents of ICAP, presidents and delegates of the SAFRA regional bodies, fellow colleagues, excellencies, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, Assalamu alaikum. On behalf of the Institute of Chartered Accountants of Pakistan, its council, its Golden Jubilee Committee, it gives me immense pleasure to welcome you all to the concluding conference of the Golden Jubilee celebrations, testing times, reflections on present and future. The year 2011 was declared by the Council as the Golden Jubilee Year of the Institute of Chartered Accountants of Pakistan, marking 50 years of its unmatched and glorious existence. Indeed, of upholding integrity, inculcating professionalism, and enhancing quality. It is a great honor for me to extend our heartiest felicitations and congratulations to this August gathering, our great fraternity of chartered accountants, and all those who over the years have directly or indirectly been associated with our prestigious institution for being part of this glorious journey of 50 years. 5 decades ago, the foundation of ICAP was laid through the enactment of Chartered Accountants Ordinance 1961, providing us the opportunity to start our voyage towards establishing an institution which has become the hallmark of professional excellence and quality. Throughout this journey, the Institute remained steadfast in its vision and matured into a distinguished body of professional accountants, growing steadily from a very few members initially to many thousands now, making their mark and presence felt both locally and internationally in the development and growth of various spheres of business and economy. During the 5 decades, our peers have not only laid a solid foundation, but progressively strengthened it by continuous hard work with the best of their abilities, dedication, and commitment for the ultimate success of ICAP and growth of the accounting profession in Pakistan. It is indeed an outcome of their unwavering commitment that we today take pride in becoming to a renowned, well-respected, and responsible professional institution. We owe them all our greatest appreciation and must recognize their untiring efforts. Please pray to Allah Almighty to bless the souls which departed this world during this journey. They are not with us today, but have left behind cherished memories of their good work and contribution towards the success and continuity of ICAP. Some of our founding members, past presidents, and senior colleagues who are among the architects of this great institution fortunately are sitting with us today in these happy moments. I request the House to give a big round of applause for their valuable contribution towards the success of chartered accountancy profession in Pakistan. It was indeed an honor for being nominated as chairman of the Golden Jubilee Celebration Committee, which was formed by ICAP Council to plan, organize, and carry out various activities and events to commemorate this historical milestone. However, it was a big challenge also as to how we should move with the celebrations, particularly considering the state of turmoil and various serious catastrophes that our beloved country has unfortunately been facing in the recent years. One option with the committee was to stay in a somber mood and restrict itself to some limited celebrations. The other alternate was to move with full courage, pride, hope and enthusiasm and celebrate the Golden Jubilee year in a befitting manner with the pride and grandeur it deserved. In addition to many factors which inspired the committee to take the courageous path, a message received in the last week of October 2010 from the Chairman, International Auditing and Assurance Board, Professor Arnold Schilder, was also instrumental toward this direction. I would like to share with you a few important lines of this message. Quote, "Dear friends, once more I would like to thank you and Jim Silf, Executive Director, International Federation of Accountants, joins me for the wonderful days in Pakistan. We enjoyed the many public and private meetings. We learned a lot about your impressive country and had great fun as well. In the plane to Dubai, I read in the Financial Times, London of October 21st, an article titled, Pakistan, the state that refused to fail. It concludes, if Pakistan can survive a year like this, it can survive anything. This is precisely what we learned from the speech of your chief guest and the whole of our visit." Unquote. The said article in the Financial Times had highlighted various natural and unnatural turmoil and catastrophes being faced by Pakistan, whether it be the earthquakes, flood, war on terror, crisis of governors, displacement of people, weak economy, and whatnot, and at the same time the resilience of our nation to fight back and survive in all conditions. The punching lines of the conclusions of this article were, quote, "The world is rightly alarmed in the mayhem that rages at its center, but if you care to look on the bright side, you might conclude that if Pakistan survives a year like this, it can survive anything." Unquote. Considering these challenges and having full faith and trust in the resilience of our people, your Golden Jubilee Committee unanimously decided not to be pessimistic, come what may. And therefore, we proceeded with full vigor and dedication to organize tens of events to very graciously celebrate this historical milestone of the Institute of Chartered Accountants of Pakistan through a structured campaign all across the country to cherish the past and envision the future. This is the true belief and the reflection of the fact that we as a nation can survive, grow and smile in any difficult situation, and this will remain so always with the blessing of Allah Almighty. All the shining faces sitting in this wonderful event are also the reflection of the resilience of our profession and the nation, which is not afraid of any pessimism or turmoil. Accordingly, the start of the Golden Jubilee celebration, the committee promised a wonderful and joyous experience for the members, students and associates of the Institute, and I hope that we have lived up to